and gentlemen, from the Pretty Reckless, Taylor Momsen.
Yeah. Hey, guys. How's it going?
How you doing today, Taylor?
I'm doing very well. It's early for me, but I'm stoked to be here. How are you guys doing?
We're doing great, man. You know, we're here at this live event, and I know that we're excited to be in front of a live audience. You recently, I saw your Instagram post announcing that you guys are headed back out, and I couldn't believe it had been, it's been 4 years since you've played live shows, correct?
Wow.
Yeah, it's crazy. Time flies and has stood still at the same time. No. So we are so excited to get back out there finally. It's been way too long, and we just can't wait. We're just so excited.
That's a great way to put it. It flies and stands still. It's the same sort of thing. We had a big event here in the parking lot last night, and people were out and in getting out of sort of the cocoon, like the chrysalis sort of effect, and everyone was sort of stunned but thrilled to see humanity out and about again.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, we've been rehearsing now for months, and we're just revving to go. So it's gonna be a great tour. We have the first two shows in New York, playing some little like warm up shows just to get our feet wet again in hometown, and then we're off, and we're going around the world for the next few years. So it's we're very, very excited to play these songs for people in person.
Have you guys announced those dates yet, or is that still coming as far as venues and ticket sales and all that?
It's ticket sales and announce is still coming. The first two shows we just put up, I think they're sold out now. But the full tour is going to be coming soon, so just stay tuned. Very soon.
I have to tell you something. Not a morning goes by when Preston, at some point, we're playing some of your music, doesn't say, God, she's got a great voice.
Listen, I want to say this, Taylor, because I'm a listen to the radio kind of guy. I don't grab the whole album and spend a whole lot of time. It's just something that hasn't been part of myself for a long time. So I mainly hear the singles that you guys release. But I was listening to, I kid you not, the other day, Only Love Can Save Me Now, and I realized that you guys are my favorite current rock band right now because that song, it's got everything I want in it. It's got crunch and balls to it. It's got tempo. It's got a really, really catchy hook to it. It's got great harmonies in it. And I'm like, this is it. This is what I want out of music.
Oh, man, thank you so much. So that's certainly one of my favorite songs on the record. And, like, I'd be remiss to not mention that it, you know, it has the amazing Matt Cameron and Kim Thayil of Soundgarden on it. So it's not put that up, you know, maybe a bucket list song for me. I'd be lying. So I'm so glad you like it. Thank you, man.
Yeah, no problem. When writing these songs, when you guys collaborate and get together to put these down on paper, how much of this ends up on the album? How much of it sets aside? Or do you use everything that you have, or do you guys have bits and pieces still laying around by the time you're done?
I mean, there's always bits and pieces lying around. It's, you know, I think when we put together a record, we try to write the best songs possible. You know, we're always kind of trying to beat ourselves from last time and really create a collection of songs that say something that, you know, cohesively go together. So inevitably there's always little remnants that, you know, don't quite make the cut, but you want to go with your strongest, best foot forward. So
right.
that's generally how it goes. Because you write bad songs in between writing good ones. You know, they're not all gems.
Yeah, listen, I've heard the theory that if you write enough songs, you know, if you keep writing, you're going to write some bad songs. You're going to write a lot of bad songs, but you're going to write some good songs eventually. And so you just keep cranking it out. Any truth to that?
100%. I mean, okay. I think that's the whole thing, is that you kind of have to, the hardest part I think for me about songwriting is you really have to wait for inspiration to hit you. Like, it's something that you can't force, and it's just, that can be a very torturous process of not knowing when it's going to come, where it's going to come from, if it's ever going to come, you know, it's this, and you don't know where it could come from anywhere. It could come from like just talking to you guys. It could come from me looking in the mirror. Like, it could be anything. So it's that's always the hard part, is having something to say and something to write about that's, you know, important. And you just don't know where that's going to come from. So it's always a blessing when a song comes through. It's like, okay, one down, and then you go, oh, crap, now what? Now I have to do it again. And so it's this kind of never-ending process, but it's certainly the most rewarding one.
Well, the pain is part of the joy, you know, as well, that you get to do this. I was thinking about you, Taylor, because we had a band on earlier. It's a straight-up, it's a girl punk band, 17-year-old, 18-year-olds, called Froggy, and they were tearing it up. And I have to imagine that seeing you, you know, on the scene and rockers, like, you know, and not to default to the classic. Wow, women rockers. But it's got to be. It's so cool to see so many people, so many women out doing this, and to see these girls embracing like hardcore punk. It was so amazing. You must get a lot of people. You must get a lot of young ladies contacting you as an inspiration. It has to be the case.
Yeah, I mean, especially, I mean, with the internet age, I mean, everyone can write everything, and you know, you see some of it. But I'm missing the actual connection with fans, because when we're on tour, I mean, the amount of people that you get to talk to and meet, and fans of, you know, to sit there and go, you inspired me. And it's like, that's such a high compliment to me. It's the highest compliment. If I can inspire you to pick up an instrument or play music or express yourself in some way, like, that's awesome.
Right.
Hey, watching you on Instagram, right around Halloween, I saw you walking around Walmart dressed as a witch. Is that something you normally do?
Yeah, you know, it's just a casual everyday Sunday. I love Halloween, and like, I felt like I had to get in the spirit this year. You had to do something.
All right, I have to ask you, did you do up your, because I love Halloween too. I love horror movies. I love the whole damn deal. I'm constantly being told that, yeah, that's a kid's thing. I'm like, no, it's a lifestyle. Do you do up the house? What's that?
A little bit. I do up the outside, and I carve pumpkins, but not too much inside. I already have too much clutter, so.
All right.
The haunted graveyard of a billion guitars, so.
Nice. Hey, Taylor, I have a technical question about one of the songs. One of the first songs I heard from this new album was Death by Rock and Roll, when that came out, Time Track. And in the chorus leading up to that, so I'm a drummer. There's a bar that's in 5/4 leading into that. And it's not 4/4. It doesn't go. It's not comfortable. It has a bit of tension in it. Did you put that extra beat in there on purpose to add a little bit of tension to that?
I mean, everything's intentional, or they're happy accidents. But everything, there's not a note or a beat or anything on this record that wasn't intentional. So, yes. To
okay.
Your question,
all right. I thought so. I liked it. I was like, ooh, that was a neat little thing as a musician.
Sometimes
that
happy
I noticed.
Accidents turn into intent.
Right.
But, which one came first, chicken or the egg? I don't know. But you know, you don't leave anything without surety.
Okay. Well, listen, I wanted to ask before we let you go, and I have a feeling that, and I don't know if you can tip your hand or not, but you said the dates and all of that of the tour is forthcoming. Can we expect something in Philadelphia while you guys hit the road?
100%.
Okay.
It would be a tour if you don't come to Philly. I mean, I don't exactly have the date for you yet, but
right.
We will absolutely be in Philly, and we miss you guys, and we can't wait.
Excellent. We can't wait either. Well, Taylor, thanks for coming on this morning. We appreciate it. MMR loves you. Philadelphia loves you, and we'll see you soon, okay?
Awesome. Thanks, guys.
Taylor
love
Morrison.
You.
She's awesome.
She's great. A hell of a voice. That band has got a real awesome rock grind to it. I love them.